about childhood and just using your imagination, that idea of never growing up, being free to be creative, be who you want to be. And it's a story that kids love, and boys and girls both love it. We decided that to structure the day, which is from 9 to 4, which is a long time for the kids, we'd bring in workshop teachers, we would have craft sessions, dance sessions, and then do blocks of rehearsal in the afternoon. And so far, the kids seem to be loving it. What draws me to working with kids the most is watching them grow, because they grow so fast and their improvement level, it just skyrockets immediately. And it's really fun to watch them be really anxious about something, nervous about something, and then the next day they get a little bit more and a little bit more, and eventually they come out doing more than you would have necessarily thought they were capable of. And it's amazing, because every time my mind is blown, and it's kind of addicting. When we first opened registration, I was kind of expecting to get, you know, like 25 7-year-old girls, but to our surprise and delight, we had almost 50% boys. They have been up there dancing, they have been so game to make costume pieces, make necklaces. Everybody's just been able to express themselves. These aren't all theater kids, these are kids who like sports, these are kids who have never done theater before in their lives, and then some kids who do theater who are, you know, have taken voice lessons, who take dance. And so all of them are able to come together and help each other grow and learn new things, and it's been really great to see.
Before she gave us the results, she said that every one of us would be getting lines. And I was like, well, then I don't care which one I get. And then when she got to me, she said, JJ, Peter Pan. And I was jumping up and down. I was so excited. It was awesome. It felt so good. When I rehearse my lines, I basically just go into my room and I just read them over. And then when my mom and dad get home from work, I have them rehearse it with me.
Everyone else thinks I'm wonderful.
You took all the credit for saving Tiger Lily.
Didn't I save Tiger Lily?
We both did.
Sure.
You're conceited.
I know.
Well, you shouldn't be.
Okay then, I won't be conceited.
First and foremost, I wanted the kids to come in and just have fun. That was my main goal. And I wanted them to be exposed to professional theater, because this is a professional theater set. And to also dip their toes into different aspects of theatrical expression and creative expression, because we've had dance classes, puppetry, lots of different, you know, we've had sort of yoga-inspired things, movement workshops, vocal techniques, so just everything, so that they can see maybe where they would fit in the world of theater if they choose to continue.
It was a camp about, you know, it's fun play, but, you know, we also get to enjoy all the friends, the counselors.
How do you like just being here in general.
Yeah, it's
so
just
I don't
the
have
friends
to stay
that make it
day.
Awesome.
And I like making my, like, my necklace and my stuff and my tutu.
Well, I've liked the most is I've made a lot of friends. I thought I would only make one or none, but instead I made a lot.
It's helped me build up my courage to be able to do this. And now I'm like, I've got this, I can do this.
Our goals for the education program are to hopefully offer a whole assortment of scholarships. And that's gonna require getting the word out to donors and sponsors, letting people know that we have an education program here, and get people on board who wanna sponsor kids who wouldn't be able to come to camp any other way. My hope would be that maybe one day we can take our classes or a shorter version of these camps to other community organizations and reach people who maybe can't travel to the theater or travel to the studios. There's so many kids in the Raleigh area who are just looking for a place to express themselves, and this can be that place.
I'm absolutely gonna come back. This is awesome.